Welcome to the .NET MAUI Carousel Control tutorial. The .NET MAUI Carousel Control provides an intuitive interface for navigating through a collection of views, offering options for scaling and rotation transformations as needed. In this video, I will show you how to add the .NET MAUI Carousel Control to a .NET MAUI application. I will demonstrate how to customize the item height and width, programmatically select an item, customize the animation speed, and customize the gap between selected and unselected items. Additionally, I will show you how to display carousel items in a linear arrangement and increase the space between items in a linear view mode. Before you begin, ensure you have installed the latest version of Visual Studio 2022 with the required .NET MAUI workload. You should also have one of the .NET SDKs installed on your machine. After installing the necessary tools, launch Visual Studio 2022 and click Create a New Project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, select the .NET MAUI application and give the project name and location. Next, create a project with the .NET 8.0 framework. Now, the default application is ready to use. Before moving forward, let me take a quick detour to set up the application's environment. I select the Android emulators from this list to see the output in the Pixel 5 emulator. Next, I'll run the application to show you the default output. The application compiles the default code in a few seconds. Now, the application's home page is displayed. Next, let me show you how to incorporate the carousel control into this application. I need to install the Syncfusion MAUI Carousel NuGet package. So, I open the NuGet package manager and switch to the Browse tab. I search for the Syncfusion MAUI Carousel package, select it, and install it in my project. After the package is installed, I need to register the handler for the Syncfusion core to map the cross-platform control API to the native view API. I open the MAUI program CS file and add the Syncfusion MAUI core hosting namespace. Then register the Syncfusion core handler by adding the configure Syncfusion core method. Registering a trial license key is necessary to use the Syncfusion MAUI controls. So, I open the AppSAML CS file and add the register license method with the trial license key. To find out where to generate it, please refer to the instructions link in the description below. Next, I navigate to the main page XAML to initialize the control. I remove the default code from the content page section and import the Syncfusion MAUI carousel namespace. Now, I initialize the carousel control. You can populate the carousel view using the carousel item or item template. In this example, I will use the carousel item. I import the existing ViewModel class. In the ViewModel class, there is a property named carousel_items, which holds a collection of carousel item instances. These instances are created and added to the carousel item's property inside the constructor. Each carousel item has its image name property set to an appropriate image name. These images are already stored in the resource folder. Then navigate to the XAML page, import the namespace of the view model, and bind the view model to the content page. After that, in the carousel, bind the carousel items list to the item's source property. Look, 6 images are displayed. The first image is visible, and the other images are stacked on the right. While swiping, you can see the images moving. To programmatically select the third item, set the selected index property to 2. Check here, the third item is selected. In the previous output, a moving animation could be seen while swiping the item. To decrease the animation speed, set the duration property to 1000. By default, it is 600. Now you can see that the animation speed is decreased when swiping. Next, let me show you how to customize the item size. To customize the width, set the item width property to 150. By default, it's 200 for mobile and 250 for desktop. Similarly, to customize the height, set the item height property to 250. By default, it's 300 for mobile and 350 for desktop. Before running the application, remove the selected index and duration properties. As you can see, the item's width and height are customized. Next, to customize the rotation angle of the unselected item, I set the rotation angle property to 30. By default, it is set to 45. Note that if the angle value is positive, it tilts the right side item inward clockwise and the left side item inward counterclockwise. Otherwise, if the angle is negative, it tilts vice versa. Looking here, the unselected item tilts to a 30-degree angle. Next, let me show you how to increase the gap between selected and unselected items. I will set the selected item offset to 60. By default, it is 20 for Windows and 40 for other platforms. Once the application is loaded, I will rotate the emulator horizontally to show the gap clearly. Now you can see that the gap between selected items has increased to 30 on both the left and right sides. Similarly, you can also increase the gap between unselected items. To demonstrate that, set the offset property to 60. By default, it is 40 for desktop and 18 for mobile platforms. Check here, and you can see that the gap between the unselected items has increased. Now I will show you how to display carousel items in a linear arrangement. The carousel provides two built-in view modes, default and linear. Previously, you saw the carousel items arranged in the default view mode. To customize it, set the view mode property to linear. Before running the application, I will remove the rotation angle, selected item offset, and offset properties. Now you can see the carousel items arranged linearly. Next, to increase the space between items in the linear view mode, set the item spacing property to 60. By default, it is set to 12. See, the space between the items is increased. In this video, you learn how to add a .NET MAUI carousel control to the .NET MAUI application. I demonstrated how to customize the item height and width, programmatically select an item, customize the animation speed, and customize the gap between selected and unselected items. Additionally, I showed you how to display carousel items in a linear arrangement and increase the space between items in the linear view mode. To learn more about carousel control features, check the documentation link in the description below. I have also included a link to check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI control suite. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.